In the last class, we discussed about different voltage stresses, over voltages and all. And I told you that from this class onwards, we will be discussing about high voltage generation. And in your syllabus, you have to learn high voltage DC generation, AC generation, as well as impulse generation. So first, let us get into high voltage DC generation. First of all, what purposes these are used in generation? The first purpose is basically it is used for scientific research.
Okay.
Since most of our equipments are working on AC, high voltage AC, so even our testings are mostly done on AC system, AC only. So basically high voltage DC is used for scientific research, for different purposes. And since now there is a lot of advance, there are lot of things going on in high voltage DC equipment or high voltage DC systems, some of the testing equipment need a testing voltage which is high voltage DC. So these are the two major things that we are that is why we are making high voltage DC supply.
Okay.
Then if you take other examples, like in some of the biomedical equipments we are using high voltage DC. One such example is X-ray. I think you know, right? In X-ray, in order to make an X-ray, you need a high voltage DC supply. Or if it is a scanning electron microscopy or any other such equipments, in such equipments, in order to generate this high velocity electron to flow, you need what? You need a high voltage DC supply. So these are some of the applications of our high voltage DC needs. Okay, so now let us see what are the types of generation in high voltage.
Okay,
what are the types of generation in high voltage? Mainly, how can we convert AC to DC? The one application you might be already studying in power electronics, or you are familiar from your first year courses, is that one way is what? Rectification,
right?
One way of making converting AC to DC, that is rectification. So for generating DC, we will be using one method, will be rectification,
right?
And another one, this we I think used studied in your higher secondary classes. Another one is using what? Electrostatic generation. Electrostatic generation. So that is the another method, electrostatic generation. And what you have learned is what? Van de Graaff generator, right? So this Van de Graaff generator also we will see in the second session. First we will see what are the rectifier circuits. So because that is one efficient way of making what? DC supply. You are using what? Silicon diodes. And we will use silicon diode to rectify our AC and convert it into high voltage DC. So these are the two types of generating high voltage DC. So in this part, we will first see the rectification. And in rectification, first circuit is halfway rectifier. Right? There is halfway rectifier, full way rectifier, and all. So you are familiar with. So first let us see the halfway rectifier. And the main component in rectification is what? The main component in rectification is the diode.
Right.
So what does a diode do? What is the characteristics of a diode? Whenever your diode is forward bias, right, means whenever this is the anode and this is the cathode. Whenever anode potential is higher compared to the cathode potential, we call it as what? Forward bias condition. Under forward bias, your diode just conducts whatever is on this side, right? Or it acts as a short circuit. And whenever your diode is reverse bias means what? The reverse of whatever I said before. Like compared to anode or cathode, if the potential is higher on the cathode side compared to the anode side, then we say that your diode is reverse bias. Under that condition, your diode will not conduct, and that we can call as what? An open circuit. So your diode is quite equivalent to just a switch, right? Whenever forward bias, the switch is closed, and whenever open, whenever reverse bias, your switch is open.
Okay.
So this is the condition, or this is the working that you are going to see in a diode for a half-wave rectifier,
right?
So now let us see the supply voltage that is applied here. Supply voltage that is applied here is what? This is your supply voltage Vs, an AC voltage. And its maximum value is Vm, right? Vm sin omega t is your AC voltage. So, and your maximum value is what? Vm, right? This is the time, with respect to time. So, that is Vm. Right? In an AC voltage, you have positive half cycle as well as negative half cycle. In the positive half cycle means what? Here you have positive and here it is negative. Under that condition, what about the diode? The diode will be forward bias, because on the anode you have positive potential, on the cathode you have negative potential. The diode is what? Forward bias, and that is why your diode will conduct. So whatever be the potential, what is the potential applied here? Okay, let us say Vs is here, the secondary voltage Vs. So whatever be the voltage here, the same voltage will come on the this terminal, right? Why? Because this is forward bias. So we can draw here, this is the output voltage. Output voltage is taken across what? The RL load resistance. This is the output voltage terminus, V out, and that what will be the voltage coming here whenever this on the positive half cycle? In the positive half cycle, your voltage that will be along this will be what? This it will be directly conducting. Whatever voltage applies on the primary on the transformer secondary side, that will be given to load, because this diode acts as what? Closed switch. So you will have the complete positive half cycle on the output side. Now, what will happen during the negative half cycle? During the negative half cycle, what will happen? During the negative half cycle, your diode is what? Diode is reverse bias. Right? Diode is reverse bias. Means what? Here you have your this positive and negative terminals are reverse, you can say. So this is will be negative and this will be positive. And you will have what? Here you will have positive and negative potential respectively. Because of that, your diode is reverse bias. Once your diode is reverse bias, you will not have any current conduction to the secondary, or this will be equivalent to an open circuit. So this part of the negative half cycle, you will not have any output voltage. Or during the negative half cycle, you will not have any output voltage. So this will be there will not be any conduction. Okay. And once again the next half cycle comes again, what? Again the same condition will come, that your diode will become forward bias. Diode will become forward biased and it will be conducting like this. Sorry. Your diode will be forward biased like this. So this is what how a halfway rectifier works under normal condition. Right. What is the problem with this? Our aim is to have a high voltage DC supply, and using a halfway rectifier we will have only pulsed DC. Right? This is what pulsed DC. Like during the positive half cycle you have, and during the negative half cycle you don't have. Like, and it is half cycle is only coming. And it is just above the zero voltage. Other than that, it is again what pulsed DC. You want to have a better or what more or less what constant DC supply. Right? You want a more or less constant DC supply. For that, what we do is that we will connect a capacitor across this load. We will connect a capacitor across this load C, which is also called as what? Smoothening capacitor. Right? Let us see how it is going to smoothen this DC. Now the DC is what? Now the DC is pulse, and let us see how this capacitor is going to smoothen the DC. Let us say, like, first your capacitor, this diode is there, during the positive half cycle, when it is conducting, definitely what your capacitor is getting charged. So let us say the capacitor got charged to this point, plus Vm, right? Once this capacitor is charged to plus or minus, this point is what? This is Vm, okay? When that capacitor is charged to plus or minus, plus Vm, then what will happen? Once this plus Vm is reached, potential is decreasing, right? But once it is reached to a high potential, what will happen? Then this capacitor will take some time to discharge through this RL. Why? So we attach the capacitor, and before getting into what happens, let us once again see the diode operation. Like, I have marked these two points, 1 and 2. When the diode will be forward bias, whenever your V1 is greater than V2, right? Then what? Then your diode will be forward bias. And whenever V1 is less than V2, then your diode will be reverse bias, right? Means this is a higher potential, this is a lower potential. That is what is meant by V1 greater than V2. And V1 less than V2, what? The reverse. So this is the condition for forward bias or reverse bias. Okay. That, keeping it in mind, we will see the operation now. So, since when your supply voltage is applied on the positive half cycle, from this point to the peak value, see, your diode is in the forward bias, let us say. So, because of that, what? Your capacitor will get charged, right? Capacitor will get charged to plus VL, right? Up to this point, what is the condition? Like, you have the supply voltage here, and on the second terminal, you have the voltage, whichever is given by what? That is the capacitor voltage. So, whenever your diode gets charged, here what you will see, the capacitance voltage across. Once it reaches Vm, then afterwards what will happen? Once this reaches Vm means what? Maximum voltage to which the capacitor is charged. Then that is the potential at the second terminal. On the first terminal, you again have the same supply voltage like this. So, once the Vm is reached, then your first terminal is going through what? This potential, and your second terminal is having what? This potential. Okay. So, afterwards, what is the condition? Here itself your diode got reverse bias, right? So, after this point, the potential at 1 is coming down, and what potential at the capacitor voltage is what? It is C. Let us now see that it is Vm. Okay. So, once that is the case, then this diode is reverse bias and this capacitor will start discharging through this resistor R. That is what is happening. The diode will start discharging through this resistor. Okay. So, let us say you have the capacitor and it started discharging. Then this discharging will depend on what? Discharging will depend on this resistor. Okay. The time constant is given by RL into C. You already learned. So the capacitor discharging will happen like this. Right. Whenever it is negative half cycle also, since this potential is higher compared to this potential, always what? Your diode is not going to conduct through during the whole negative half cycle also. In the positive half cycle, again your discharge is happening what means what? From plus Vm, your capacitance voltage is decreasing to some extent. Okay. And your supply voltage is what? Supply voltage is independent of that. And whenever your supply voltage again goes to the next positive half cycle, and whenever it is crossing the voltage of the capacitor, means the condition of this one, means what? The capacitor voltage is becoming lesser than what the supply voltage. Under that condition, your diode will again start conducting. Diode conducting means what? Your capacitor is again getting charged, and it will get charged like this. Okay. So this principle is known to you already. So this is what is going on with the smoothening capacitor. So without smoothening capacitor, you have what? You have a pulsed DC on one half cycle, next half cycle you don't have, and next half cycle you have. So that DC, we are able to make it like what? We are able to make it more, what I can say, it is lesser pulse, though we have more regulated supply. So this is the condition when you have a smoothening capacitor, the red curve as shown in this figure. Clear? Now let us see some more things here. Like, you have this much part, the capacitor smoothened voltage you have, right? Now first of all let us discuss about ripple. Okay. What is meant by ripple voltage? Ripple voltage means you are not having a constant DC voltage. Instead you have some variation in the DC voltage at your output. So that is what we meant by ripple. So here this Vm corresponding to this value Vm corresponding to V maximum, and the lower value whenever the condition when what when your voltage is becoming higher and again starts charging. So this value is what? V minimum. So there is, before getting into ripple, as we discussed, this is where your diode is getting on, because it is getting forward bias, right? And to what period? Up to Vm only. Once again Vm happens, diode will become reverse biased and you will have capacitor discharging through the load. So only during the small period, from whenever it is becoming higher, and but with the Vm, this is the period when your diode is getting what? Charged. So the diode is forward bias, so diode is conducting, right? So this is the whole period. So this is where your diode current will be there. Whenever this capacitor was not there, then all the positive half cycle your diode was conducting. You will have a complete conduction during the positive half cycle in a diode. But whenever you have smoothing capacitor, the conduction period has reduced towards this small period here. If you see at this region here, again it will be like this. So this is the region where your diode is conducting 4 watt in order to charge the capacitor. Okay, so this is what is happening in the diode in the half wave operation. This have a due to this reason there are some disadvantages with the half wave rectifier that we will see. So before that, let me explain ripple voltage. Okay, ripple, what is meant by ripple? So as I said, your voltage is varying between what this Vmax and Vminimum, and it is not a constant value. So we define ripple voltage delta V as what? Vmax minus Vminimum divided by 2. Understood? The average value of this ripple happening. So your delta V will come to one, whatever be the small voltage in the average of this voltage V max minus V minimum by 2. And another parameter is the ripple factor. Another parameter is the ripple factor. Let us call it R. Ripple factor R is defined as delta V. Delta V means what? That is a ripple voltage. Delta V divided by the mean of the voltage. V bar. Delta V divided by V bar is the ripple factor. Understood? So this is given by ripple factor. And when it comes to testing, there is a rule about this ripple. Means our ripple voltage should be lesser than the ripple factor, delta V by V bar, that should be lesser than or equal to 3% according to most of the standards in testing. When you are making a high voltage DC, the ripple voltage, ripple factor should not come above 3%. So that is the rule. Clear? Now let us see the limitations. So getting into limitations, first this capacitor is getting charged, right? From this period to this period, your capacitor is getting charged. And from plus Vm up to what? Up to the next time, your capacitor is getting discharged also. Right? Your capacitor is getting discharged also. So the load current means whatever load is whatever be the load current which is in the going to the resistor RL, right? You remember that resistor RL, that will be equal to what? The current IL going through the resistor RL will be equal to V load. This is V output, okay? V output of T divided by R, right? That will be the load current. Means whatever be the, this is the waveform shape of your output voltage, and since we are dividing it by what, resistance only, then your load current shape also will be just similar to your output voltage waveform, right? And let us say, since it is like charging and discharging of a capacitor, let us speak in terms of the charge. What is the charge given by? Charge is always current into time, right? Whenever you have a voltage, whenever you have a voltage which is varying, just as our case is now, then what? It is V output of T dt, but what? IL of T, right? IL of T dt, right? If we integrate it over time, current into time, if we integrate it over time, we will get the total charge, right? Over what? Over the time period T. What is the time period? If we are seeing this waveform, it is what is the repetition of this waveform? If we start from here, let us say if we start from this point, from this point 1 to what? To this point 2. It will repeat the same waveform again, right? So the time period for this output voltage is what? Time period for this output voltage is the time T. Means the whatever be the supply voltage time period, the same will be your. If you take the distance, if you take the time from this to this, from positive peak to next to positive peak, that will give you what? That is the time period of your supply voltage. Same will be the supply time period of your output voltage also. So over the time period T, if we calculate the Q, integrate it over IL dt, we will get what? The charge in a period. Right. So over a complete cycle of AC, this is what the charge which is given to what? Which is given to the load. Right. So the same amount of charge the same amount of charge, when you take the diode, the same amount of charge need to be taken from what during this very small period. Okay, the small period, the same amount of charge need to be taken from the supply, from the transformer. Right? You had a transformer on the primary side, and from the transformer you have to take the same amount of charge which is getting discharged in the load during a small time period. During a small time period, this here. So, due to that, your current, this is the diode current, right? Due to that, your current will be what in pulsating in nature. And what, as I said, in our normal high voltage DC circuit, since the load RL, this RL value will be very higher. It will be mostly equivalent to what the current will be equal to 0. That is the condition under testing. Mostly in practice, we will see what current is approximately equal to 0. Since we are testing what, we are not going to give 100 ohms or 200 ohms. We are going to give mega ohms or giga ohms, which are what insulating material, so that very less current conduction will be there. Right. But whenever this, even in testing also, what we might be doing breakdown test. Whenever this high value of insulating resistance, it may start conducting. Under such conditions, your discharge current will not be something like this. Your resistance is becoming very less, so that what your current will be very high at a particular small amount of time. So that time, on the primary side, what will happen, since that much charge is needed during the diode conduction period, it have to take what very high amount of charge also. So due to this reason, your transformer as well as what diode, these should be in very much robust in nature. Means it should be able to withstand that. And depending on that, on a half-way rectifier, when you design it, your first limitation will come on transformer. Like your transformer should be designed considering what it will not be designed for as a normal case. Your transformer should have a special design. Okay. Understood. Transformer should have a special design in incorporating all these problems. That is one major limitation. Another one is that since we have an asymmetric waveform shape here, right? We have an asymmetric waveform shape means what? This is what your one period is looking like. So that is an asymmetric waveform that we have. And what we are looking into, is having a more or less constant voltage, and your ripple will be comparatively higher. Your ripple factor will be comparatively higher. As I said, this is a pulsed, the pulsed nature of current in the diode as well as in what in the transformer. The pulsed nature of the current in the transformer means what? That can cause that can lead to saturation of the core. So the charge is given by integral of IL dt, right, over the time period t. We discussed this before. So, and that we can write in terms of what output, V output of t divided by RL into dt. Means the current, the load current waveform will have the similar shape as our output voltage waveform with ripple, right. So, this is the charge. And V output of t divided by RL, since this is a curve like this, we can take it as what? The V output of t divided by RL is the mean current value I, and what we are, when we integrate over the time period, then this is the time period given by IT. So this we can write as I divided by F also. Means t, when t is the time period, then 1 by F will give you the, 1 by t will give you the frequency. So that is I by F. That clear? Now, since we can see that our capacitor is getting discharged through the resistance from what V max to V minimum. Between this period, this is the period, right, wherever your capacitor is getting discharged. So what is the voltage levels that means through which your capacitor discharging? So that will be given by what? V max to V minimum. This is the interval. And delta V is given by V max minus V minimum divided by 2. Means this is this much amount of voltage, from here to here, this much amount of voltage is what? The ripple voltage, delta V. So 2 times that is the voltage level through which your capacitor is discharging. So charge is also given by what? Capacitance into voltage, CV, right? Charge is also given by C into V. So that you know the capacitor, and through which voltage it is discharged, that is what? 2 times delta V into C. So your IT here, in terms of current, whatever formula you got here, the same we can equate it to what? 2 delta V into C. So 2 delta V into C will be equal to I into T. From that we can find out the ripple voltage. Ripple voltage given by what? If you take this equation, rearrange it, it is given by IT by 2C, which is equal to, again, time the time period, if we change, represent in terms of frequency, it will become I by 2FC. This is the equation for ripple voltage. One important factor we should see here that since ripple voltage, even the ripple factor, that will have major dependence on what? Frequency as well as the capacitance voltage. Mainly frequency. When we think about high voltage DC with lesser ripple, we always go for higher frequency. We don't try to generate at what? At 50 Hz. We will try to generate at higher frequency. As your frequency increases, what will happen? As your frequency increases, then what? Your ripple voltage should come down since it is in the denominator. So that is what we normally do in generating high voltage DC with a halfway rectifier. So we have discussed the operation of halfway rectifier, and so what a diode does, like whenever you are not having a smoothening capacitor, then you will have a halfway rectified output, which is quite pulsating. And by applying a smoothening capacitor, you can make the pulsating nature of DC voltage to a much better extent. But again, we will have a ripple voltage. And due to the capacitor charging and discharging phenomena, your transformer and diode, they should be robust. Or you should have special design for a transformer here. And even it can lead to the saturation of the transformer core and similar problems. So these are we have seen the limitation as well as the working of halfway rectifier in this lecture. Next, we can adopt full way rectifier and other things, other circuit topologies for making high voltage DC, which we will cover in the next lecture.